Mr. Ben Wheatley, you had the incredibly challenging task of creating a character that's not physically present, but you see her all around, you can feel her, you could almost grasp her influence. My question, though, is very straightforward. How did you do it?
It's a lot of different bits. I mean, some of it's art department, obviously, and kind of the creating of her presence in the house, which is like the, you know, her bedroom is a big part of it. And we imagine that she'd come from, you know, she was from London, and she was bringing the modernity of London to Cornwall, into Mandalay, and that came in the shape of Art Deco design, which was about as modern as you could get at that point. Some of it's in the music, so there's a lot of things that Clint Mansell's doing there in terms of like themes for Rebecca. So you feel her in terms of in the soundscape and the sound design and stuff. And then a lot of it's about the way that the characters all react and talk about her. You know, she's built
from totally.
Basically, and people talking and kind of building her up. But then you've got this thing of like, what's true? You know, which elements of this Rebecca are the real Rebecca? You know, and I get the distinct feeling that we're not being given the correct picture at all from any of these people necessarily.
And going back to the adaptation process, you're adapting something that was already adapted by Alfred Hitchcock. That movie won Best Picture at the Oscars. You must have felt like you had something new to say, or a new way to say it, or was there an entirely different reason you took on this project?
Well, I mean, one of the things is that this is the second, you know, after the Hitchcock adaptations is the only other cinema adaptation that's been made of Rebecca, and the, mm-hmm. and the Hitchcock adaptation leaves out like a major plot point of the book. I think that was one of the main things that intrigued me about it, was to come back to the book and do the book properly, you know, and they were restricted because of the Hayes Code. Like, there was, you know, the law at the time in America restricted them from featuring characters that commit crimes that then get away with them. So they had to change it, and it kind of really changes the structure of the whole story once you've done that. So so the Jane Goldman adaptation screenplay that I read, I just thought was fantastic, you know, and that kind of drew me in. And then I went back and reread the book again, and just realized how modern the book is, you know, and that it's interesting when you look at cinema and when you look at literature as well, that a lot of the DNA of the thriller lives inside of Rebecca, really. And I think this is why it's still held in such great high regard. But it's also done things that haven't been done that don't tend to be done in cinema, which is the idea of having characters that commit, that are morally appalling, but that also are the heroes of the film, which then, you know, that manage to get through the whole movie without being punished. And I think that was really interesting.
I think I have like 1 minute left. What's the status of the Tomb Raider sequel? Are you still directing? Are you going to film soon?
It's everything is on hold because of COVID at the moment. So it's you know, big productions like that are really difficult to put together because of the restrictions. Certainly ones which like travel all over the world, it's just like, it's not going to happen. It might be an adventure that she has like under a table or something in Croft Manor.
Right. You know? It was supposedly set for March 2021, but I think it's safe to say that wouldn't happen.
I don't know. It's you know, I couldn't possibly say.
Well, thank you so much for your time. It was an honor.
Cheers, man. Thank you.
Buffett. The terrace is for guests only.
Monsieur, the young lady will be joining me. What did you do?
I'm a lady's companion.
Maxim de Winter. His wife died last year and is in dire need of company.
I'm Monsieur de Winter.
What are you doing?
Oh, you'll see.
This week, I'd like to never forget it.
Come to Mandalay. I'm asking you to marry me, you little fool. Mrs. De Winter, may I present Mrs. Danvers?
Welcome to Mandalay.
Never seen a house like this.
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you'd been a lady's maid.
This is all very new to me.
Oh, I'm sure you won't disappoint him, madam, if that's your concern.
We did a lot of entertaining when the late Mrs. De Winter was alive.
You can talk to me about her.
I have no secrets from you.
All marriages have their secrets.
Has Max ever talked to you about the accident?
I don't know what you're talking about.
How am I supposed to know anything if you don't tell me?
She's still here. Can you feel her?
I'm tossing and turning all night.
Rebecca.
Bad dream.
She was the love of his life.
I wonder what she's thinking about you. Taking her husband. Using her name.
He doesn't love you.
I said I want the truth.
You didn't know her. You know what he did.
He can't go on living in that big old house with her ghost!
I don't believe in ghosts.